They made it so like it comes up with saying V exorbed Virgil or something to basically so when you go Devil Trigger, you turn into Virgil. That would have been sick, but you never know, they could do, but I don't think they will, to be fair. But it does seem, because I kind of seen the videos of people playing as Virgil, but obviously it's a mod, but he is in the games, like, coding, in a way. That's the reason why they did it, because Virgil's actually in the coding. And it's like, why would they put him in the game if he's not playable? Because he's even... They've even gave him his alternate colour as well, his red, when he's in red. Because that was the colour that he got on 3. Because you could play as him on 3, on Devil May Cry 3. But them making the DLC, it probably won't happen. Just have to wait and see. It's like, well, it's plus, it's like even saying with Bloody Palace. This is normally a thing that comes with the game straight away. It came with 4, it even came with DMC Devil May Cry. It came with 2, it came with 3, and 4. If I already said them. But for this, it was an actual DLC. But no surprise there, since nearly everything nowadays, you don't really get a full game, do you? You gotta pay for DLC! But at least this was free. And obviously they made it even better that, oh, we've brought achievements, yeah. It's like even with that, I'm even surprised they've even brought achievements with it. Because, same again, Capcom don't really do DLC for Devil May Cry games. And like it's like even with Resident Evil 2 remake. That came out with DLC and it had achievements. It's like, whoa, because the only game that they really do that with is Street Fighter 5. Well, Street Fighters. That's the only game that really comes out with DLC because it's obviously Street Fighter. Nothing else. Because they could even make it so with DLC it carries on, but probably not. Because obviously it could give them. It could just give them the reason to make the game. In a way. Wait, I don't... Plus with some companies, they prefer to make a new game because then more people will get it in a way, because it's obviously a new game. It's like the Resident Evil 2 remake. Since it's an absolutely fantastic fucking game, that it's basically a fan service to the Resident Evil fans. Because I say the only thing that I didn't like about Resident Evil 2 remake is that I couldn't play it with fixed camera angles. I say that's the only thing I didn't like about it. That's my own opinion to it. Is that I couldn't play it with fixed camera angles. That's it. And then it's like, Capcom made that, and then obviously this came out, and it's same again. It's pretty much just a fan service towards people that love Devil May Cry, including myself. But there is there is a little bit of nooks and crannies about it, though. with the whole, the one, you can't cancel a swing. Like, you can't actually cancel the moves. You can, but you've got to wait. You've got to commit to the swing first. You can't automatically cancel it. This is coming from a game that, from number four, you could go fucking mental. If you know how to press the buttons and shit, you could do fucking all sorts. It's like even, because back on four, I changed the button layout. Because it's obviously originally, it's pretty much the same. It's four. Y is to attack, X to shoot, A to jump, and obviously on thingy to do the grab, it was obviously B. But this time it's the gloves, it's the his arm, whatever. But obviously when you beat the game and you unlock Devil Trigger, you have to do the grab, you have to press right trigger. And then it's pretty much the same, keep your finger on RB to do the grab. That's pretty much it. But back on that one, if you full on practiced with Dante, Jesus fucking Christ. Like mixing Trickster with Royal Guard plus the enemy hop, you're a fucking cracker. You're basically playing how Dante would fly in real thing. That's how it is. You're just all over the shop. Teleporting everywhere, fucking cancelling shit. All because of enemy hop. That's the one thing. Ever since, enemy hop's been in the game since one. The first ever game. But the first ever game was just, it wasn't a hack and slash. It was more of a, I'm pretty sure it was actually Karagorid under horror. It was action and horror. Because this was back when, this is like when Capcom made a new game, and this is coming from Resident Evil. And then it's like, even Devil May Cry 1 is pretty much Resident Evil like, but you can actually kick the fuck out of everything. That's pretty much it. It works the same, fixed camera angles, stuff like that. You slow pace. Oh, I pick up this big, dirty, big, massive sword. Can't use it, though, because it's a fucking key. Why can't I use it? This is obviously coming from Resident Evil type stuff. Oh, you find a grenade launcher. I've got some bullets. Can't use it, though, because it's a key item. I need it to place it in this thing to open this door. I can't use it. That's what pretty much Devil May Cry 1 was like. You get this sick looking weapon, and then it's like, you can't use it because it's a key item. Because the one thing that I would love to see from Capcom is, since Resident Evil's technically got remade and it's perfect, I want them to do it with Devil May Cry 1. I really do. But it has to be fucking perfect. Give it the same treatment that Resident Evil 2 got. Completely remake the game. Because even Capcom even come out and said that if people want a Resident Evil 3 remake, we will do it. And of course, mate, they probably will be even making it before even 2, whilst they were making 2. Since Resident Evil 2 and 3 take place in the same place. I think Resident Evil 3 is set a month after 2, or it's like before 2 or something. So they've got the game, they've got the place, but you just play as a different main character. That's it. Because the main thing that they made different as well with Remake is Mr. X, the way that he played. It kind of works like a nemesis of Resident Evil 3. Nemesis appears, you hear him, it's like, right, he's fucking coming for you. If you let him get near you, he's going to fuck you up. And obviously, that's what our Mr. X works. You hear him spawn, and then he'll just constantly keep coming after you. And that's how Nemesis worked on 3. Because Mr. X on 2, he just appeared in certain areas. And then that's it. But Nemesis, he full on, there was sequences for him to appear. You do something, you pick. I want to jump, say, it comes up with like a load of sections. It's like there's one, you're on a bridge. And it says, right, fight Nemesis or jump down. And obviously, and it basically turns, it's just like a different arc coming away. But it is kind of fair that Resident Evil 2 got remade first, because Resident Evil 2 pretty much made Capcom who they are. Because when that game came out, fucking hell, it came out for the 64. Was it also the PlayStation 1? I could be wrong. I could be right. And it's like, this game basically bumped up Capcom in a way. And then obviously Resident Evil 3 got made. It's like, well, fucking hell. They've done themselves a good again. And obviously for some years Capcom, they went down in people's books, but nah, they've come back because of this Resident Evil 2 remake. And obviously Resident Evil 7. But I have not played Resident Evil 7. That's the one Resident Evil game that I have actually not played. I've played every single one except for that. All because it's in VR. I want to play it in VR. I'm not playing it without VR. Do I really want to fork out nearly 400 quid just for one game, just to play it in VR, to be fucking blown out of my mind since I've never used a VR? But it's like, do I really want to do that? Plus, with that game anyway, that was just to sell it, to, in my personal opinion. Resident Evil 7 being in VR was the selling point for VR. It was like, right, we need to make a game that's going to make people buy VR. And Resident Evil 7 was that. And obviously, a lot of people loved it. Since it's just set of nothing, it's just like a whole new thing. But it's in VR. Obviously, if I was walking around and I seen it, Resident Evil 2, Resident Evil 7 with VR, by 100 quid, take it. So I've already got a PlayStation. I just haven't got VR. Because I'm also a big, big, big Dark Souls fan. I love my Dark Souls games. And I've got that Sekiro game and I've not played it yet because of this. Plus, I'm a type of person, I've been starting to do it. Before I didn't do it. I only play games when I'm finished with the one game that I've been playing. So technically, I would have been playing that game, but this came out, and obviously they've added DLCs with it. So obviously, I mean achievements. So I'm obviously gonna get the achievements. Because I'm not one of those type of bitches where I'll play a fucking game and then I die like nearly 50 times on fucking trotting this game shit. I'm not one of those type of fucking pussy bitches. You automatically think a game's shit because they've died like 50 times on trot. Obviously, this is coming, like I said, I'm a Dark Souls fan. This is coming from a Dark Souls game. Plus, one of my all-time favorite games is Devil May Cry, so it is kind of the same thing, but one's just more fast-paced. Plus, I pick them up very fucking fast. That's another one. Dark Souls type games, I pick it up very fast. Kind of like when I played the... when I played through Bloodborne for the first ever time. Never played it. Never seen it, watched no one play it, nothing. So I'm also one of those type of people that if there's a game that I really want to play, I don't look it up. Obviously, that's the whole point of buying the game. What's the point in you? Oh, I want to buy this game, and then I go and look it up. It's like, what's the point of buying it? You just looked it up. You've just basically just seen someone play it. Then it's like when I was playing through Bloodborne for the first ever time, first playthrough, everything, the amount of people that came into my stream watching me play it and they were saying that I was bullshitting, that I've never played it before. They were saying I was bullshitting about it. That I have played the game before. worst thing is coming out tomorrow, and all fucking Borderlands 1 remastered. The one on 4 is way better. tomorrow.